So as of now, guys, we have seen how we can test SoapUI web services. Okay, so now I'm going to show you how I can do it for REST-based web services in SoapUI. Along with that, I'll be showing you for two other different tools. One is the popular REST client tool that we'll be using for Firefox. Now it's available for Chrome also, Advanced REST client. So REST client is the popular tool for REST-based testing, and for Chrome I'll be using Postman. Okay, so let's get started. Okay, so for my case, for REST-based testing, I'm gonna use the Gmail Google API that has been provided. So if you search us on Google, Google API, we'll get a lot of list for that. I mean, Google API library, just found it, product API library. So I told you guys what is API and what is about REST. For REST, it stands for representation of state transfer. So each and unique resources in the network can be identified by a specific URI. Okay, that is stand for uniform resource identifier. That is, that may be a name or an URL. Okay, so Google is providing all this kind of API: Google Cloud, Google Cloud Machine Learning, Google Maps, social apps, mobile apps, G Suite API, YouTube APIs, advertising, other plus. So many APIs Google is providing so that we can incorporate or embed the same API in our applications, and we can access the Google features through our applications. So it will just bind our application to the Google particular Google applications. So take an example for Gmail API. So I mean, for that I'm coming it later. Let me open it this way. Okay, so for Gmail API, if you go to the reference Gmail API, then go to the reference, you can see that you will be able to, there is a lots of HTTP request, get, post, port, post, delete, everything is there. So how we can get the same for your applications, like for user levels, or like just an example, for if you want to get some specified level as if like this is my specified level, inbox tier, send mail drafts. So if you want to get some specific level, how we can get it, you have to get request for that. Okay, providing the user ID and ID, then you will be having all those details to be displayed in your response. So the simple thing is that we are going to manipulating, we are going to accessing the Gmail through our applications, and for that we need some connection, right? So Google API, Google has been provided their Gmail API through which you can connect our app to the Gmail. Okay, so let me get straight to it first. And so first we have to create one REST-based project. So to create a REST-based project, just click on the REST, and you have to provide the URL name. Okay, so URL name, it's the Google API thing. So see, this Google API access.com. So from this, I am accessing all my APIs. So I've just provided the name here. Not this one. Copy. So just to provide the name and clicking on OK. I'm not going to do it because I have already created one Gmail list API. See, I have just given this URL only. See, it already automatically fetched the accordingly if WDL file is available for that. So it fetched the WDL file, and then I saved the same XML file. I saved the project to this particular folder. So just create, click on the SOAP REST request. Provide whatever the API has been located. This is the main part. Here is your API has been located. To provide that, and just click on OK. So it will be added. Let me click on OK. Let me show you. Okay, so this is the end point. So this is as well. So see, for REST-based project 2, with this has been created. Okay. So just delete it as of now. Already I've created the same project. Save project before we know. I don't know how to save it. This is my project. Let me open the request. Not this one. Okay. So this is my request for get user profile. So if I want to get the user profile details, so I have to set the request. This is the endpoint that I mentioned, and this is the resource for this, the Gmail v1 users user level. This is the resource I'm for under this endpoint. I'm fetching this resource. Okay, so this is the resource you have to mention accordingly. Parameter is there, you can also mention different parameter. Okay, so I have used parameter for as a resource level only, not the parameter level. So I have taken parameter, created one parameters that I have used in the for resource level only. Okay, so let me and the most important thing is that when you have configured this, so I just click on the OK button, it won't work. If you click on that, it will get unauthenticated and 401 failure. Okay, unauthorized. So after setting these things, you have to get your the authentication. So for Google API, it uses the Outh 2.0 authentication. So initially it was Outh 1, now it is the Outh 2 authentication. So for that, your application should get the access for accessing the Gmail, right? Suppose your application is trying to access the other the Gmail facility, so there should be some connections, okay, some authorized connection or authorized code through which you can get the access. Then only the Gmail will provide their response here, their mail ID or the label ID to be displayed in the application. So for that we need the authentications, and Outh-based authentications, so we need to provide the several things. Like if you see the authentication header, we need to provide authorization grant code, we need to provide client identification number, client secret, then authorization URI, access token URI. This is for basically URL, redirection URI is not mandatory. Scope, whatever the scope you want to get, like it's for metadata scope, your raw data scope, data response as a raw format, full, your format metadata, your format JSON. So you have to mention the different scope, like for fetching the mailing at, all of your message from your email. So accordingly, all the scope has been mentioned there, like this way. See, for if you want to access this particular label, the scope has been given there. This is the scope, okay, metadata labels read only. So scope is mentioned there, and apart from it, you can also write your automation code for that to get the scope. For that, Google has been provided a sample code, how do you get automation code for Java using a Java app. So list of options has been provided. Using you can get your automation code based on Java, for .NET, for Ruby, Perl, for Python, different language. All this has been provided by Google itself. So let me close it. Okay, so first thing, we have set up these things. Okay, and the next thing is that if I just click on that, let me see, I've configured this before. Method not allowed, something error response will come, and see the response. 405 method not allowed. Get me profile, let me edit profile. Search on it. Okay, currently you will get this error message, and if you haven't configured it, if you given not access token, then if you click on that simply. So we'll get this message this way. Okay, thing is that you need to configure your application. So for configuring your applications, either you can create you have to go to your console library, the console developer google.com. let me show you. But I can show it from here itself. Okay, let's just do it for a while. So you have to go to your console developer developer console, and where you have to create your own project. Okay, for that I have created my own project. Said after creation of your project, then you need to create your own credentials. Okay, for creating your credentials, like for I've created this credential, now it will take some time. Okay, suppose I want for SoapUI something. I've given this example, I'm not going to use it. Suppose giving you are using Soap API, SoapUI. Suppose you are soaping this way, that this is a client ID, this is a client secret will get generated. So client ID, client secret, this you will get. Okay, and one more thing, whatever the library you have used, I have used the Gmail API, so I need to enable it. Simply create on dashboard and enable it. Currently see the Gmail API is enabled, right? You can also disable it. Okay, disable Gmail. No, I won't want to disable. So I have enabled it. Then I created my credentials. I got the client secret and client ID that I'll be using for authorizations of this, so that I can get the requests in, and whatever the HTTP request I want to do, accordingly it will be done. Okay, so for authorization purpose you need this, all those things. So another, first you need to get your first you need to get your auth client ID, like auth client secret, and if you want to create again, so let me show you again. Auth client ID, other Postman. So this is how you can get your client ID and client secret. So after getting your client ID and client secret, now you have to register your app. The app you have already registered, okay? So after registering your app, you will get the client ID and client secret. Now you have to provide the access token URL and authorization URL that has been provided by your API provider, okay? So all these things after provided will get the token response, access token. So same, what I'm doing exactly for here, authorizations, I'm choosing authorization. If it is no authorization, then nothing will be resolved. I'm choosing auth by authorizations. So here I'm giving options. I have to provide the access token. If I don't want, I don't know the token, I want to generate the token. So get token, here I have to provide current identification, client ID that I've shown you guys. This is the client ID and this is the client secret. Authorization URI, access token URI will be provided by your API provider, and then whatever the scope you will mention, and click on get access token. Similarly, for if you navigate to my this is my Postman app for testing, for testing race based application. So what is Postman app? If you just search on that, let me show you. So Postman is a Google Chrome app for interacting with the HTTP API. It presents you with a friendly GUI for constructing requests and reading responses. So it's for basically REST-based web services. We can send different type of HTTP request and we can get the response accordingly. And we can also perform our testing over there, okay? Says the ID has been provided by the Google Chrome, okay? So interacting with HTTP APIs. So just add this to your extension. See, for my case, I've added this already as my extension. Close it first. This is my Postman that I have added as ID Chrome. Click on the launch, it will get open. So it's opening right now. So just as I was telling you that you have to authorize before you can send your request, get request from the Google, you have to authorize your applications. So similarly, same thing, if I want to do, the same thing will be applicable for here also. Like for authorizations, if you see that currently there is no options, okay? Currently there is no options. So now you have to authorize those things. So click on Outh. Google is currently using the Outh. If you click on the get new access token, see if you'll get a token name. You provide the token name as per what you want, but you have to provide the Outh URL accordingly, the Outh token URL that is provided by your API provider, and a client ID, client secret. I told you guys how you can generate your client ID and client secret through the developer console. You have to register your app first, through which you can get your client ID and client secret. You need to provide this and a scope that is optional. I can also provide, and grant type authorization code I will be selecting. and then for request access token, then will be access token will get generated. So you can also get the request access token this way. So you have to provide a lot of information in that case. Suppose you do not want to do that, I mean I'm telling you easier way to get the access token. Okay, so for getting access token easier way, just go to the developer Google developer auth playground, just search on that Google auth playground. Okay, let me close this ad. So you can see Auth 2.0 playground, the Google developer. Just click on the first link, that will come. So I already have created that Auth. I'm already in the Auth playground site itself. So see the step one. In the first step, you will get lots of API that is Google providing. Okay, the C thing is the fitness, fusion tables, G Suite, genomics, Gmail API. Just hold on, it's not scrolling down. Okay. So lots of API that has been provided by Google, you will able to see. Let me just. It's not working. First you will navigate to this page, then you have to select whichever the API you want to use. So lots of API has been provided by Google. Let me just close this also. It will take some time. I mean, I don't know, I've checked from Mozilla, Firefox, and Chrome. All I said some time, a few seconds. So all this API has been provided, YouTube API, YouTube reporting, task, so the lots of API has been provided. Now, which API you want to use for your applications? Like for my applications, I want to use the Gmail API, okay? So just click on the Gmail API and wait for some time. So all the Gmail API listing will be opened, like for Mail Compose and Gmail Insert, Creating Labels, Metadata, Modify, Record Only, all those things will get opened, okay? Settings and sharing, all those things. So all those things, when you check on that, basically you can manipulate those things through the API from your applications, okay? Because it will be connected via the authorizations, okay? So all this API under this operation I will be doing all this. Select all that. I'm selecting on the Gmail API all these versions and click on authorize API. I already have clicked already, so not gonna click second time. Okay, you click on that authorize API, it will take you to a Gmail page where you have to give the permission to access the API. Now we will get to the second step, exchange authorization code for tokens. So first you will get authorization code, now you have to generate your tokens. So if you click on that, bad request, but let me select authorize API. So it's taking me to my Gmail, and you have to provide all this. You have to allow all these things like read, send, delete data from mail. Through this API, I want to manipulate all this kind of operation in my Gmail. So I'm allowing all these things currently. So the first step is done. Successfully authorize the API and allow it, and. Next thing, next thing, we are coming into the second step, exchange authorization code for tokens. Here is the authorization code. Now click on that exchange authorization code. Clicking on that. Okay, so I have successfully clicked on that. For the request response, I am seeing as okay. So token has been generated. That is my token, and every token will get expire within 1 hour. So it's starting from 3600 seconds. And if you do not want to expire your tokens, it has been there is options like Play Store, Doesn't Store, Refresh Tokens, but as Refresh Tokens never expire, you just should go to their Google account authorized access page if they would like to manually revoke them. So if you want, if you do not want your access token to be expired within the 1 hour, then you can do the necessary, okay, to authorize the access that will be active for all the sessions, not only for 1 hour. So just as of now, I mean, we have seen that we have generated access token. Now I'm going to access that. So copy that access token. That access token I will be using for SoapUI. So paste that access token. Okay. So I will already paste the access token as a authentication. So in the authentication, I'm pasting the access token. Okay. Now, one more important thing is that when you are accessing this Google profile, like support ticket example, user labels get not this one, suppose user get profile. Suppose this is a simple HTTP request I want to send, and user ID is my mail ID. So just put me as a mail ID. If we can obviously this options to try this API in the Google console itself, just you have to make sure you have a login in that. Click on execute. So it's coming response as okay. This is my mail ID, total message 231, thread total and history ID, everything is getting displayed. Response coming as okay. So this is working fine now. So the thing is that when you'll be doing for the SoapUI, so after authorization of this access token, given the access token, one more thing you have to do, you just to have access, you have to provide a same access token that will be passing as a header. Okay, so I'm providing the same access token that has been copied from this this one access token. I'm passing as a header, authorization basic. Okay. So in the request header, I'm sending this access token and it's connecting via auth properly. Now I should get the response, right? So see, format it is not needed currently. ID is not needed. I will come to it later. Just for this case, you can just delete these options. Format, delete the options. So user ID I'm using at resource level. Okay, we have different options. So I'm using for resource level. So see, users, user ID, profile, or you can simply write this value here also. I'm providing as a parameter. Now just click on the get request. What I think I'm getting is you can leave, you cannot be Google XML method not allow, but why get user profile view on users. This is my access token. Header options. Here also given URD upload Gmail. Okay, I made a little mistake. So I want to get the profile, right? So this will be, I'm given wrong things, upload. Okay, got it. User ID I'm passing. Okay. User ID I'm passing this way. Now click on the get. We can see the response as a JSON. So that's coming, it's trying to, but cannot be as XML. So we check, we are getting the response as a email address site.qf14 gmail.com total message total thread history ID. So everything is getting displaced. Okay, so get user profile, I'm able to successfully get the response. And if you see the response, you can see the response from is 200. Okay, or we can see the response header also. Response header also, this way, like it's okay. All these things coming properly, that I just check for this for my case. Okay, so thing guys that I have done using the SoapUI, and I'm gonna show you for the same thing you can get in Postman also. Just you have to do these things, like for Postman, for SoapUI I have passed a header like authorization basic. Okay, for Postman a tool, and just pass authorizations, what authorization as the authorizations BRR. So add a header value like authorizations. If you want to configure it auth-based authentication, you can do it. And if you don't want to do, just pass the authorizations token value as a header BRR value. Okay, So passing as the key authorization, the value will be BRR space, that token number you have to provide. Okay. Now if I just check the request profile, I click on send, it's saying it's not found. Why? Okay, got it. Why? Because this token has been expired, I guess. The old token. This is the old token has been given. Let me paste it again. Okay. Now send the request. It's again telling me that it's not found. I made some fault with this user's user ID profile. Just copy that part. I'm doing actually wrong operations. Just it is a get operation, right? So just let me get. Okay, so I'm getting the response, that the same response that I got for SoapUI, same for this default Gmail API executor, and so same API I'm using for Postman also. Okay, the response that coming, raw response. Okay, preview, this is the response coming. You can also perform your test over it. So for test, and you have to check response time coming is less than 500 milliseconds or not, all those things, if the response status queue is 200 okay or not. So all those things you can perform. So I will cover these things later, like we have different options to create snippet or perform a test, code is 200, all those things we have another options. Okay, so I'll cover the test later. I'm just showing you guys as of now how we can get the response for a REST based protocol using SoapUI and Postman RestClient. And if you just for an example, if you navigate the SoapUI RestClient tool, for that we are also having that same, we have to mention the authorizations value as a VRR, and we need to provide VRR space. VRR space token. Click on OK, and profile I want to get, right? Just send. Click on send. It's telling it's not found. Why it's not found? Just get the percent. So it's coming, showing there is 200. Okay, successfully got. This is my email address. This is the email address in JSON format I'm getting. Okay, so this way you can get, you can utilize your Outh Gmail API and to get the responses utilizing that API. So for RestClient, it's a Firefox based ID, a Postman is a Chrome based ID. And for SoapUI, you can also perform the reservoir services. Now next, let me experiment this little bit further. Now suppose you want to get the total, get the message along with the message ID. Okay, let me just close it as of now. And I want to get the message ID. So my message ID, all this API listing and the API resource set library will be provided by your API provider. Okay, so message ID you want to get. So just click on that user message. And the request, what request you need to provide for getting the message ID. Okay, so we can see that we can set the request as a this HTTP request, this is the endpoint and this is the resource, and inside the resource two parameter passing user ID and ID. Okay, so ID is the message ID of your ID is a message ID of your particular message. Okay, so you need to provide the message ID. But if you don't know the most message ID as of now, first you have to face the message ID. So click on list. Okay, so it will list all the messages along with their IDs. Okay, just copy that part. Get user message. Let me create another new method here. Method name will be like get messages, get ID of email messages. Response is get. Property I will create later. Let's call it why this one moving? Or let it be as it is. So if I open the email message, get ID of the email message, I will get this portions. Now I have to edit that part. Endpoint also provided, we don't have to do anything. Gmail user ID, user ID I'll be passing as a parameter. Message, okay. So for the same thing applicable for error also, we need to do the authorizations auth based token. Auth token is getting generated. Either I have to add authorizations for the same cancel it getting the profile so request authorizations authorizations basic. Make sure when I'm using performing SoapUI, just mention header as authorization basic, and I won't be doing for REST client and Postman, mention that as authorization BR, okay? Authorization basic, value access token I'll be giving from here, okay? Let me just change it also, public access token, I put the get request. See the different response. Okay, so see, I mean, now we are able to see all my Google's all my Google's message ID along with the thread ID, everything is this total. All this thing has been displayed properly. Okay, now if you want to fetch my particular message, so I do send the ID. Okay, so for if I send the ID over this API endpoint in the resource, I will get the particular message also. Okay, now. So if you want to get specified message like this way, it just listing all this ID, and if you want to get this message this way, like get user messages, not this one. We don't need this method, I guess. So you got the response of all this ID. Now suppose we're gonna get some particular message details, so I have to provide the pass the ID. Suppose this is my ID, yeah, this is my ID, okay, and I have to provide it. Okay, so let's see the API Explorer. I mean, if you want to get the message, provide your string email ID. For this message, as I just shown you guys, this is the ID for which I want this message. Format you can put like full, metadata, minimal. This is a parameter, okay, like full, I want as a full format default. String metadata headers you can pass. Also, it's not mandatory. Then scope you have to select. As of now, scope or order has been given, just let it be. If I click on execute, its response coming is okay. So for that particular message, I'm getting it's like snippet as Sumit goes commented on your video history ID something all delivered to whichever delivered when I've received along with. So everything I'm getting, okay. let me just we don't have the options here. Okay, so just copy that part. So all these things, whatever the message will be encrypted here, and whenever the message has been sent and which date, which part, meme type, file name, and who has in, all that ID thread along with all these things we'll get. Okay, just you have to provide the ID, so user ID and ID. User ID you have to provide. For same case, you have to provide a user ID slash here. If you provide your ID, you will get all these details. Okay, all those details will be get. So face the particular message you can also get. Next thing I'm gonna show you, we have seen that how you can fetch messages and you can say in the get response. Now what about the other response like put, delete and post? Okay, so for that I'm gonna showing one example. Like I will be creating one labels and deleting labels and updating labels. Okay, labels is just like if you take you to my Gmail, let me refresh it. Okay, so see the label is like he has a Gmail, compost, inbox, stared, stent mail, drafts, more, under more important chats, all mail. So this is all the labels. Okay, so you can also create one label. So if you click on the create new labels, it will get created a new label. Okay, so send mails, inbox, all these are kind of level. I want to create one label, delete, rename one label and delete one label. Let me show you for Chrome Postman tool. Let me, I am going to show you for from the RestClient tool, and then last I will be showing for SoapUI tool. So let me do it from the Postman tool first. Okay, so first you need to get the for creation of label, I need to post it, right? So this is my URL. User ID is dn.qa for, you can also pass it as a parameter. As of now, just writing this way. You have the options. So header parameter this way. You can also, you can params, you can also mention. Okay. If I use as user ID, user ID. So the important thing is, guys, if you click on that post, you also have to add the, if you're posting something, so you need to add your response body, right? Let me add this method response body. That's about name as the postman, name as a postman. Okay, a message level visibility and height, ID postman, type type I'm not sure about that actually. What is the type? Well, just keep the type portion as of now. Okay, so let me just pass it, copy paste the same body. Oh sorry, this is a response body actually. For post, see bodies into this thing. So for post, if you are doing post operations, so I need to mention all these things body. Okay, options you can pass it as a choose as a body, as a text, JSON application, support JSON. So you can also choose raw. I'm choosing as a JSON because it's a JSON format. And now I'm clicking on the post. Okay, it's showing a bad request. Let me just delete that portion. Let me send it again. Let me check it over here. Let me send it. Execute. Bad request global invalid. Invalid unhide is. Unhide is not a valid value. Okay, message list PhD. So this is not a valid value. Just close that. Okay, just I want to create the name. Okay, the thing is that guys, it is not unary, it should be like show. Okay, message list ability show. So message list ability show, and label list visibility label show, label show. Okay, this is the body. Body format you will get. Delete, paste it, send it. It's again showing bad request. Why? For ID. Not sure why it's showing. It's okay, right? Gmail labels user ID @gmail.com. Everything is fine. Send it. Parse error. Okay, if I just send the name only. Okay, so ID has been created with the name postman _1, and it is by default show, and level is visibility show. So I'm able to create a new label postman. Let me take you to my mail, refresh it. So first time postman is created with the Google API, and then this one that I've created, it is using the second that I've created through here. Okay, that postman one that departs the body, created one body, so successfully post the request and created one postman label here. Okay, now I want to delete this postman, this label. Okay, so I can delete it. What is the ID? Label ID is 5, so make note of that ID. And if I'm gonna delete it. For delete, you have to provide your ID. So for delete, just click on delete labels. Labels, you have to provide your ID. Label 5. Okay. Don't need your body. So ID has been provided. Everything is provided. Now click on send. So it's showing successfully the status. 204 is a no content, and it's successfully deleted. Okay. So what is the response? Yes, so what is nothing up there. So it's successfully deleted. Let me just refresh my postman _1 should be deleted. It should not be there. I have just deleted it. So see, it's been deleted. Now only remain is postman. Only remain is postman. So this ID is postman underscore 4. Now if you want to update it, just put using put, you can update it. Let me show you your put options for update. If you want to change the name, name update postman. Now I wanna update this ID 4 with body JSON body. Name should be update postman. Okay, so this will be updated. Postman will be update postman. I'm clicking on the send button. Cannot read property as of undefined. There's an error. 200 SS. Okay, it's coming. Let's see. So update postman. Okay, so label has been updated. So you have seen, guys. First, we have created one ID and just deleted one ID, and we can also update request port also via port HTTP request as a port. So you can also update that. So this, so you can manipulate, I mean we can use our Chrome Postman RestClient RestClient tool to send our data, send our HTTP request, and to get the relevant actions. Okay, let me show you for REST client. I wanna create a new ID. I wanna delete the new one, delete that ID. So delete. So now it's showing postman, update postman. I wanna delete the ID. So ID is for that ID is ID is 4. Okay, ID is 4. I want to delete the ID via REST client. So just copy the same thing. Just click on send button. Two zero four content. So it has been successfully deleted. Okay, I'm getting. So if I just go navigate to my Google Gmail inbox, Gmail, and just refresh it, we'll see update postman should not be there. Say update postman is not there. Okay, it's been deleted successfully. So guys, we have utilized this platform. You can utilize the Google API that's been provided, and you can do all kind of operations if you want from your application only by sending it as a REST request. Okay, so let me create one label from SoapUI also, and update from, and we'll update it from the REST client, and then we'll delete it from the SOAP. Okay, so for SOAP you can easily do it. Just a new method, it should be post. Create a new label. Click on OK. To create a new label, user underscore labels is ID. Labels. As a name, SoapUI. the SoapUI and click on send button. It's really not found. Why? User ID. Oh, user ID to provide. Authorization secured. Authorizations have to provide. Just copy the same authorizations. Okay, just write it. To configure this first, send. So ID with SoapUI has been created successfully. Label SoapUI, and if you wanna create another one, SoapUI_2, just click send button. SoapUI_3, send button. So ID is 678. This three IDs created. You just refresh it. See SoapUI, SoapUI2, SoapUI3, these three ideas have been created. Now I want to rename it as a REST client, REST different name. Okay, so just clone method, cloning that method. Update a new level. Obviously, this request will be for put. For put, I want to update it, so I have to provide my ID. So, I can update. I have to provide the ID ID level underscore 8. Name I want it as a REST client. All errors configured, just click on send. Sorry, it's not passing as a parameter. I'm passing as a template. Listen, so ID has been changed to REST client. Okay, similarly, if I want to change for ID 7, advanced REST client, click on that. It changed for 7 also. If I change for 6, demo. So successfully put uses the put operation, put method, and I've successfully updated these things and getting response as okay. So let me just go over and click on that. So all this field will be updated as per what I have done as update operations. Okay, so you will update it this way. So see, it's basically advanced REST client, demo REST client, and REST client. So it has been updated this way. Okay, now suppose I want to delete some particular ID. So just create a new method, clone method, delete level. Auth header given. For delete a person, you don't have to put the media type. Just keep that part. And label 6, you want to delete. Just click on that. Two 04, no content, successful. 2 0 7, this one also delete. So successfully done. It's also 2 0 4, no content, successful. So demo rest and rest client should not be there. Assume successfully deleted. See, all this thing has been, only the rest client is there. I'm going to delete it using the using my rest client. Just delete the options, delete level. Sent 204, no content. Just refresh on that. All this label should be deleted. See, successfully deleted. So, guys, we have seen how we can utilize the SoapUI and as well as also our REST client, Chrome application, I mean, Postman applications, and to send our different requests to test our application or REST based applications. Okay, the thing is that there is so many operations under the listed under the Gmail API. You can send a, you can trigger a mail, you can send a mail, you can create a draft. So all these messages like creating a mail, creating drafts, saving history, showing the details, changing the settings, all these things you can easily do if you use this Gmail API. Okay, the Gmail API has been provided. Try to do experiment with it and see if I see the options. We can options like insert a new message, listing message, modify the message, send the message to the particular requester ID, and same way all these things, all the suppression we will be able to do. So just experiment, get to know more about it from developers, Google's API library, we'll get to know. And so the thing I've created this SOAP REST request for this Google Gmail REST API. Now easily you can do just create test suite for that. I can add to test, you can easily proceed to testing with your REST based application, that is the content is coming properly or not, or it is successfully updated or not. Okay, so testing, how to carry out the Gmail based testing and putting assertion, that has been already been discussed in my earlier tutorials. That is same like for SOAP based protocol also. So for rows, these for REST, this way you can get this way you can create the new REST project, and all this WDF file will be incorporated, and then you have to mention whatever the operation is going to perform, like where perform. I have shown you guys for get, post, put, delete, all these operations using my Gmail API, and all this thing is manipulating my successfully updating or deleting all these things in my Gmail. Okay, so utilizing, so I have utilized the Gmail API. So you can also use, there is popular API like Amazon Web Service API, RESTBase, and you can also use the Facebook Graph API to know more about it, or get to know more and to learn more these things. I would suggest just check with different API person, like for YouTube has been provided their API, or you can use this existing API also, like Gmail API. You can perform several other things, so this way you can get to know more about it. So that's all for today, guys. And regarding this Postman creating runner collection, creating test suite, and creating running all our tests using this code, response code, and utilizing risk 10 also, how we can perform testing for our risk based project. I will come to it later, I will discuss it later. So that's all for today, guys, and thank you for watching. And if you have any questions regarding that setting up of risk based client in your SoapUI project, you know, what are the header sections, and what about the how to set auth based authentications, get to the client ID, client secret. So if you have any questions, please let me know. Okay, thanks all for watching.